Hi everyone, it's Erin from the Provincial Farmhouse. Welcome to my channel. Christmas in July is coming to a close, but I have one more video for you guys. This is a collection of my favorite wood round crafts for Christmas. I've put together four projects that I hope will inspire you for either your Christmas in July celebrations or save this video for when it comes time to do your Christmas crafts. I look forward to hearing what you think about these projects. I hope that you enjoy this video. Today we're going to make another door hanger, this time with the Blitz mold. We're also going to use the Jingle mold and the Bauble mold as well. We're using the amazing casting resin. This is a really quick resin. You've got a work time of about 2 to 3 minutes and then it's cured in 10 minutes. So it's definitely quite a instant gratification product there. You can find a detailed list of all the products used in our video in the description, and you can find those products on our website, theprovincialfarmhouse.com.au. The first thing I did was mix up my amazing casting resin and then poured them into the Blitz mold. Now you want to make sure that you only mix up just what you need, because this stuff does cure pretty quickly and you don't want to waste it. So I am going to make probably about 3 sets of this mold to do the door hanger wreath today. So as you are pouring the resin, you can see I'm using the end of a spoon to work the resin into all the little snowflake details. Sometimes it just needs a little help to get there. You will see that the resin changes color. It goes from clear to an opaque white, and then you're able to pretty easily pull them out of the molds. If there's any areas where the resin went over the outside of the molds, you can pretty easily pick off those little bits with your fingers or use a sharp knife. I wanted a base with some texture, so here I'm mixing Dixie Belle's Sea Spray texture additive with Manatee Grey chalk mineral paint, and I'm dabbing it on with a chip brush. You don't want to use your good brushes for this because it can be pretty hard on the bristles. I'm just dabbing and stippling it on to get some texture. Here I'm starting to plan out how I want my snowflake wreath to look. I'm just playing around with the configuration and then I'm gluing it down with a strong all-purpose glue. There were a few little snowflakes that I needed to use hot glue to adhere down. If you have trouble, it could be a good idea to cast those and then use them straight away, because the resin is flexible for about 5 to 10 minutes after you take it out of the molds. Next, I'm using the Manatee Grey paint without the sea spray to paint the snowflakes. I did end up going in a different direction with this, but this is a good example of another look you could go for. Here I'm doing Fluff chalk mineral paint over the top of the dried Manatee Grey paint. You get a really lovely sort of a wintry look with this, and I'm just sort of stippling it and brushing it on in layers. I decided I wanted to add some text to my door hanger, so I'm mixing up my resin again and pouring it into the Harper Decor mold here. I have never poured it into letters before, so this is definitely a learning experience. I did go a little bit overboard, but you have a little bit of work time, so I just sort of moved and manipulated the resin into a few other letters, trying to spread it around. When they were cured, I took them out, and any little letters that I had left over that was extra, I put those in a storage container for use later. I always like to use up the resin that I've got made so that it doesn't get wasted. I picked up this little container from a local hardware store, and I will use those letters in the future, and I've got them stored away safely.
I'm adding some baubles to my design as well. So here I'm casting a few of the designs so that I can have a bit of a play and see what works. And once they're cured, whatever I don't use, I'll just put aside and use later. Here I'm working out the configuration of my letters, and once I'm happy, I am gluing down the baubles and the letters into position. Again, I am using a strong all-purpose glue to adhere them. I also decided to add some cute little bows from the Jingle mold to the baubles. Like I said before, I decided to change directions with this piece. I wanted a more subtle French country look, so I'm using Dixie Belle's Latte Chalk Mineral Paint over the top of the entire design, working it down into all the details. Next, I'm dry brushing on some drop cloth chalk mineral paint. I don't have much paint on my brush. I'm catching all those details and I'm applying it in layers. I'm also adding it to the background texture to give sort of a look of snow in the background. I'm now applying Dixie Belle's satin clear coat to go over the top of the entire design so that I can come in with some glaze and have some control over how heavy it is. I'm now applying Dixie Belle's Grunge Glaze over the entire design, just lightly. I want to really give it sort of an aged appearance. If you've watched my videos, you know I love to do this. I try and work it into the crevices and then I wipe it back so that it's not too heavy. Next, I'm using a combination of Dixie Belle's gold and silver gilding wax. I'm using the silver on the snowflakes and the gold I'm using on the baubles, the bow, the text, and just on the smaller snowflakes as well to try and tie and blend the colors together. I then added the silver gilding wax around the edge of the round and just sort of had it peeking around the edges too. When I was done, I attached a screw-in hook so that it could be hung on a door or on the wall and so that I could attach a bow. And here's the finished product. I really hope you guys like this door hanger. It's a little bit different from my last one. I loved using the Blitz snowflake mold and the Jingle mold and the Bauble mold. They're all so much fun. And the amazing casting resin really helped. You could also use clay if you want to give this a go as well. I'd love to know what you think of this in the comments. And if you could hit that like button and hit subscribe so that you catch all my Christmas and furniture makeovers. If you want to find any of these products, you can head to our website, theprovincialfarmhouse.com.au. Thanks for watching. Today we are going to create a Christmas door or wall hanger using IOD's new Christmas release. We're using their molds Holly Lane, Jingle, and Blitz today. Before you cast your mold, you're going to want to use something like cornstarch or corn flour to make sure that your clay doesn't stick. Today we're using IOD's air dry clay. And when you are pressing your mold in, you'll find that there is a micro rim. You want to push the clay out and use the micro rim to get a nice crisp line. I always turn my molds upside down and use gravity to very carefully get my mold out. The molds are very flexible, so you'll have no trouble bending back the mold as you're working your casting out. We're applying the molds using wood glue and being very careful to get it all over the intricate details. And we're attaching it to a wood round. Now you can find these at your local hardware store and it's up to you how big you make it. So this is the larger part of the Holly Lane swag, I guess you would call it. And I've made three of those to position around the wreath that we are creating. I've also made some of the smaller elements and the little pine cones so that I can layer and really make a unique wreath. We're attaching the molds while they're still wet because they're quite flexible and we're going to be doing some layering. You can wait until your clay is dry, just be aware that it will not be flexible once it is dry. You could use resin in these alternatively as well. It just comes down to personal preference. The little bells that you see me gluing down now are from the Jingle mold, and I thought they were a very cute addition. I only did three of those though. Here I'm using air dry clay in the Harper Decor mold. I'm using this as my lettering on my sign. Now if you want to recreate this sign, you don't have to have this. You could use one of IOD's stamp sets, or you could even create your own stencil. These are quite fiddly, so you want to make sure you're using that cornstarch and that you're using IOD's clay. Inferior clay does not work very well. It was even a little bit fiddly here, especially with the letter S. You could always use resin for this step instead. Or you could wait for each letter to dry before taking it out of the mold. Once I had all my letters cast, I was planning and working out how I wanted the entire design to go. So I decided that I wanted to add a reindeer and a bow and a few other elements. So I'm adding cornstarch to the Jingle mold and getting my IOD air dry clay into that reindeer. He was a little bit tricky, and only that this clay is such good quality, I would have had a lot of trouble with his antlers. They're very delicate. Again, you could always use resin or let your mold actually dry before you take it out. Next, I'm using the Blitz molds. These little snowflakes are absolutely adorable. I was very careful to use my cornstarch. Very, very detailed designs here. So I'm working my clay in and then turning my mold upside down so that I can get the little casting out. Now, I had to do an extra one. You've got four little snowflakes. I did an extra one because compositionally, it always looks better with an odd number. Once I was happy with my layout, I got to work wood gluing all my little molds down. Now, another reason why it's good to do this while it's wet is that you're able to mold things. So the bow up the top, I was able to mold that around the bell, the bow around the reindeer's neck, I was able to do the same for him as well and make sure that I had really good contact. Once I was finished, I took a wet wipe and wiped away my excess glue. Once my molds had been drying for at least 24 hours, I came in with Dixie Belle's drop cloth chalk mineral paint and painted a base. I needed to do two coats here because there are a lot of nooks and crannies and crevices, and it will take two coats to make sure that you get into all those areas. Next, I'm using Dixie Belle's Kudzu chalk mineral paint over the holly. I'm applying it, but then I'm using a wet cloth to gently wipe it away. I wanted quite a muted look for this design. You don't have to do this step, and you can use any type of chalk paint that you want. Next, I'm adding Dixie Belle's Barn Red to the little holly berries. I'm just using a very small little artist brush to do this and dabbing it on. I'm working my way around, and anywhere I see that little holly, I'm just adding a hint of red. I'm also adding red to my little reindeer's bow and to the bell up the top. Once that was dry, I added Dixie Belle's satin clear coat to the entire piece. This is going to be a base because now I am adding Dixie Belle's grunge glaze. I wanted to get an antique look and to work this glaze into all the little crevices to bring out the details. And by doing the clear coat first, I'm able to come in and wipe back the excess and get it really to the look that I want. Here I'm really working it into the details on that pine cone because whatever glaze is left will darken and it will add some really lovely detail to those crevices. Next, I'm adding Dixie Belle's gold gilding wax. You want this to be the last step because it is oil-based. I'm using my finger and very lightly adding it to the snowflake, to our lovely little baubles and bells, just any of the details that I really want to pop. I'll also add it to the pine cones. Now, this is something that I tend to start off doing light, and then I will come in and add and build up my layers to my liking. I also added the gold to the letters to again really highlight them. Next, I'm adding the same gold gilding wax to the edge of the round using an artist brush. I'm also going around and having it overlap and show little hints of gold around the border of the wood round. Next, I'm adding a little screw-in hook to the top so that it can be hung up, and I'm also attaching a lovely little bow and some greenery. And here's the finished product. You could hang this on the front door, on the wall, you could place it on a mantle. It's just a really lovely, unique design that you can have in your home for the festive season. Now, with the IOD molds, you can create any type of wall hanger that you like. This is just one idea. You can use any type of paint. You could go bright. I went for a very subtle look here. It really is up to you and your imagination. I hope that you really liked this video. Hit that subscribe button. Leave me a comment. Let me know what you think of this. And I hope that you guys have lots of fun this festive season creating with IOD's wonderful new range. Thanks for watching. You can find all the IOD and Dixie Belle products used in this video on our website, theprovincialfarmhouse.com.au. You can also follow us on Facebook, Instagram, and Pinterest. Today we're going to be making a Christmas door hanger. We're going to be using the Noel paint inlay from IOD, the Blitz mold, and the amazing casting resin. You can find a full product list in the description of this video and all these products on our website, theprovincialfarmhouse.com.au. Let's get started. To begin with, I'm going to be making my amazing casting resin, pouring part A with part B, and carefully pouring them into the Blitz mold. I'm going to pour some out into each of the snowflakes as we're going to be using the whole design. While my snowflakes are curing, I'm going to do two coats of Dixie Belle's Fluff Chalk Mineral Paint to my wood round. I found this wood round at a local hardware store. Today we're using IOD's Noel paint inlay. It's 8 pages of beautiful Christmas designs, and these are all designed to look weathered and vintage. We are going to be using the Christmas tree farm design today. Make sure you check out my other videos. I have done quite a few projects using these awesome designs. Before I get started on the paint inlay, I'm going to arrange my snowflakes. Now, I'm going to arrange them up the top and down the bottom, so I'm going to actually cut them in half. I just want them peeking around almost like a border. Now, my resin has not long since cured, so it is still a bit flexible, so I'm using some scissors and a craft knife and carefully cutting it to size. I'm then going to arrange it in the pattern that I think that I would like, and I'm just being very, very careful as I use the sharp knife. So I used resin for this project, but you could definitely use air dry clay. I just find that I get a lot more detail with the Blitz mold using the resin as opposed to clay. Before I glue down my snowflakes, I'm going to put the inlay down and just double check my measurements, make sure that I've got the snowflakes arranged so that they're not going to interfere with the paint inlay design. I actually sort of tweaked the design a little bit there. You can see I felt like that was a bit more balanced. So now I'm gluing down my molds using a strong wood glue, and again, just making sure that everything's going to fit. Here I'm just carefully using my craft knife to trim off any excess resin that I can see going around my round edge. I'm now adding some of Dixie Belle's fluff to the snowflakes now, as it might be a bit too messy to do so when the paint inlay is down. Now for applying the paint inlay, I'm going to make sure that my surface is free of any sort of lint or debris, and I'm doing a nice thick coat of Dixie Belle's Fluff Chalk Mineral Paint. I'm trying to keep my brush strokes going in one direction and making sure my paint is on thick enough that it's not going to dry too quick and that the inlay is going to be able to be transferred. When I'm sure I've got enough paint, I'm going to put my paint inlay design side down into my wet paint. I'm then going to carefully smooth the design down, working my way around, making sure that every part of the inlay is making good contact with my wet paint. So I'm smoothing out wrinkles, making sure that I'm not missing any sections. You could use an IOD brayer for this part. Next, I'm using a mister with water to dampen the paint inlay and a damp cloth to apply some pressure. I'll then leave my paint inlay to dry. When the inlay is dry, I'm going to mist the surface again and use a cloth to sponge off any excess water. After about 30 seconds, I'm going to start to peel the inlay away. Now here, I started to feel a little bit of resistance, so I got some more water and I misted the surface before I tried again. As you're pulling the paint inlay away, you want to be gentle so that you can ensure that the design will stay in one piece so that you can use this again later. I'll pop this on a drying rack to dry. Once the inlay is dry, I'm using a 50-50 mix of satin clear coat and water to mist over my project. This is going to help seal the design enough that when I brush on a clear coat, there won't be any bleeding. So I did notice that there was a little section on the word dark that did not transfer, so I'm using a little artist brush and Dixie Belle's Anchor Silk Mineral Paint to very carefully finish off the letters R and K. Once it's all dry, I'm using Dixie Belle's satin clear coat to seal the entire piece and being very careful not to overwork the design. I'm going for a vintage look, so I'm using Dixie Belle's Grunge Glaze specifically in the details of the snowflakes and then wiping it away on the high points. Also adding a light coat of the glaze to the center section and wiping a lot of it back. I just want a hint of age here. I then decided that I wanted to add a couple of the smaller snowflakes, so I'm adding some of Dixie Belle's fluff to those and then I am going to glue them down. Also adding a little bit of glaze to the snowflakes. I had to be careful because I was doing this before the glue was completely dry. When the glaze was dry, I added some of Dixie Belle's gold gilding wax to the snowflakes and also around some of the edges of the wood round. Finally, finally, I am adding a screw-in hook so that it can be hung on a door or on the wall. And to finish it off, I'm adding a buffalo check ribbon. And here's the finished product. I had a lot of fun making this project and I hope that you guys like how it turned out. Let me know what you think of this in the comments. If you like it, please hit that like button. If you haven't already, make sure that you check out my IOD Christmas playlist. I have a lot more projects to hopefully inspire you this festive season. If you're not already, I would love it if you could hit that subscribe button and the notification bell so that you don't miss out on any of our other Christmas projects or furniture makeovers. You can find all of the products used on our website, theprovincialfarmhouse.com.au. Thanks for watching. Today we're going to make a Christmas gingerbread door hanger. We're going to be using the Noel paint inlay, the Blitz mold, and amazing casting resin. We're also going to be using the barn wood planks stamp. You can find these products on our website, theprovincialfarmhouse.com.au, and a full product list in the description of this video. Let's get started. First, I'm going to be making my castings out of the amazing casting resin. I'm going to mix part A with part B for 30 seconds and then pour them into the molds. I'll be able to take them out in about 10 minutes. While the snowflakes are curing, I'm going to get started on my wood round. I'm going to do two coats of Dixie Belle's Fluff Chalk Mineral Paint as a base to go underneath our inlay. Today we're using the Noel paint inlay. There are 8 pages of gorgeous Christmas designs to choose from. I've already done quite a few videos on these. Make sure that you check out our IOD Christmas playlist. Today we're going to be actually doing the second use of the gingerbread design, which you will see at the end here. When applying paint inlays, you're going to add it to wet paint. So here I am applying a generous coat of Dixie Belle's Fluff over the top of my two dry coats. And I'm going to make sure that I have enough paint that it's not going to dry too quickly. While my paint is still wet, I'm going to take my paint inlay and press it design side down. So the lettering should read correctly for you and the grid side should be showing up. Now I am carefully pressing down, making sure that my inlay has really good contact. Now this is the second use, so it is going to be a bit more faded and there also will be some remnants of the paint that I used it in before. I used it in a cream paint previously. So now I am misting and generously dampening the paint inlay, and then I'm also going to come in with a damp cloth, and again I'm just pressing down, making sure that I have really good contact with my paint so that all of the lettering and the images show. I'll then leave my paint inlay to dry. While my paint inlay is drying, I am taking out my castings and peeling off any excess resin from the snowflakes. I will be casting quite a few of these snowflakes for today's projects and future videos. Next, I'm painting a coat of Dixie Belle's Pumpkin Spice Chalk Mineral Paint on each of the snowflakes. This is going to be a wonderful base for our gingerbread theme. I'm then going to use a small artist brush and Dixie Belle's Fluff Chalk Mineral Paint to paint the details on the snowflakes. This is going to give it that gingerbread look. I found that if I laid my brush down at a flat angle, that I only hit the high points and it made painting these a lot easier. Now that my paint inlay is dry, it's ready for me to take it off. I'm going to mist it very well with water and also use a damp cloth as well to take off any excess. This is going to allow the paper to release. After giving the moisture about 30 to 60 seconds to soak in, I'm very carefully going to peel back my inlay. I'm going to be very gentle so that the paper doesn't rip, and if I find any resistance, I will mist the paper again. So remember, this is the second use. I've already used this before, but the design has come out pretty good. It's just a bit more of a gray color as opposed to a black, and you can see I do have some paint remnants there of my cream color. I'm now using a fine grit sandpaper to sand away a lot of the extra ridges there to give it a smoother look. After brushing away the sanding dust, I'm going to use a 50-50 mix of clear coat and water to spray my inlay. This is going to allow me now to come in, once that's dry, with a coat of Dixie Belle's satin clear coat. This is going to minimize any sort of smearing. When that's dry, I'm coming in with Dixie Belle's Tobacco Road Voodoo Gel Stain. I want to tone this and give it a vintage look. I'm also coming in with the Au Naturel Voodoo Gel Stain. Again, I want this to have a bit of a vintage feel to it. I'm then going to use the Tobacco Road Voodoo Gel Stain on the Barn Wood Planks stamp here and very gently press it over the design. Now, anywhere that it was a bit thick over the lettering or the image, I'm just rubbing it off or wiping it off with a damp cloth. I want the hint of the wooden boards. Again, this is adding to that vintage sort of a country feel. I'm now working out placement, trying to figure out how I want my little snowflake gingerbread biscuits to sit, and anywhere that some of the Tobacco Road stain is a bit dark, I'm using a wet wipe to wipe it back, and then I'm going to come in with some hot glue and glue those snowflakes down into position. I'm then going to add a screw-in hook to the top of the door hanger, and then I am going to add some buffalo check ribbon to the top. I thought that the colors went beautifully together, so I'm putting it around the hook, making sure that each side is even, and then tying a bow. And here is our Christmas gingerbread door hanger. I hope that you guys like this project. I am so happy that I got another use out of that inlay and that the snowflake gingerbread cookies go well with it. Let me know what you think of this in the comments. Please hit that like button if you like today's project. Make sure you check out my other videos. I have some other gingerbread and Christmas inspired projects in the IOD Christmas playlist. If you're not already, I'd love it if you could hit that subscribe button so that you don't miss out on any of our festive ideas this season or furniture makeovers. You can find these products on our website, theprovincialfarmhouse.com.au. Thanks for watching.